So we'll hit lock, lock, lock. We'll give it a couple seconds here to fire up. And there she goes. So the first thing that we're going to do is remove the bottom steering shroud right here. So in order to do that, we need to just pop this little cap off around the ignition ring. So the next thing you're going to do is put the key in and turn the ignition on. And this will unlock the steering wheel so you guys can remove the screw here on the right. And then go ahead and remove the one on the left. So once you got the screws out, go ahead and take the key back out. And we're going to go ahead and take a little pry tool and get in here between the two halves. And you can break it loose and it will just fall out just like that. The BCM is behind the glove box and we need to remove 8 Phillips screws. There are 4 along the top and 4 along the bottom underneath. So let's go ahead and remove those now. Once you guys have the screws out, go ahead and open it up and just kind of pull on the arm a little bit, and you'll have to get a pry tool in here. But basically you're gonna work your way around and this whole piece will come out just like this. So our BCM is the black box back here with the connectors facing towards the front. So we're gonna go ahead and loosen the BCM and rotate it so you guys could see how the connectors are orientated and what we need to tap into. So over here on the left, you're gonna see a metal bracket with like a tab looking thing on it, which is right here. So you're gonna push out on this tab away from the BCM and then push the BCM towards the front and it will come off of the bracket like that. And then there's another one over here on the right. So it's gonna be this metal bracket right here. So you'll feel a tab and you pull out away from the BCM and then push the BCM forward and it will come off just like that. Behind the glove box, we're gonna go ahead and attach the portion of our harness that's labeled BCM. This is going to connect to the white harness in here. And then we also will connect the green wire on this particular vehicle because we're going to use the factory key to press lock 3 times to activate remote start. Now, if you guys have the key without the keyless entry on the head, you will not use the green wire. Unplug the white BCM connector. There's only one of them here that's gonna match up to ours. So once you unplug it from the BCM, you're gonna go ahead and take our harness and plug it in. And then simply go ahead and plug the other end of ours right back into the BCM. And make sure it clicks and you guys have a solid connection there. The other white connector here is where we're going to attach our green wire. If you guys have the BCM orientated like this, from the top left corner, you're gonna go in one. So it's count 1, 2, it's the second wire over. And in this van, it is a light blue wire. The color of wire will probably vary in your van, but it's always going to be this location. So we're gonna go ahead and tap on the green wire and then we'll have everything behind the glove box wrapped up. Green wire, go ahead and strip back a little bit of insulation to expose some wire. You're gonna put the provided tap on here. Go ahead and crimp that down like so. Give it a tug test to make sure it's a solid connection. And then you're gonna take the provided wire tap and simply tap it onto this wire. Take a pair of pliers, crimp that on there. And then the green activation wire simply connects right onto it just like that. The easiest way to fish the wire over to the driver's side is to take the connectors and fold it back so you have a harness like this, and you guys can tape the green one to it if you want to, but go right down here and go all the way over and just simply fish and push as much as you can behind there. If you guys want to use like a long zip tie or a fish tape, you can, but this will pop out right over by the gas pedal. And then come over here to the driver's side and you'll see it poking out right here, and you can just grab it and pull it the rest of the way out. you guys have the steering shroud off, you'll see on the back side of the key cylinder, there's a white connector here. Take a flathead or the pry tool and you'll just release that tab. You can pull this out. So go ahead and feed the black connector of our main ignition harness down through the dash, and that will come out down here. And then what you're gonna do is on the main ignition harness, you're simply going to plug the factory connector into the mating portion of ours like this, and then plug the other end of ours right back up into the switch here. So when you have it all connected, it looks like this. Factory connector into our harness into the switch. And then this right here will come over here, you'll zip tie it to this main loom, and then the clamshell fits right back on. So now what we're gonna do is grab the black wire with the ring terminal on it that says ground. This is our main ground input. If you guys do not connect this, nothing will work. So we're just gonna go ahead and use one of the hood latch 10 millimeter bolts. You just take that out, put your ground ring terminal through there and re-secure it back. So the last wire we need to hook up is the white wire off of our harness, which is our parking light wire. This is optional. You guys do not have to do this, but we are going to show you exactly how to do it. So this is not in a connector, unfortunately. On this vehicle, it is coming through the firewall here at the main engine harness. So basically what we need to do is unravel this harness right here, and we're looking for a purple wire. Let me go ahead and untape this harness, and then I will show you guys how to test for the actual wire. So it took me about 10 minutes to go ahead and strip some of this tape off. Don't use a razor blade. I know it's gonna be tempting, but if you guys slice into some of these wires or short something out, it's gonna be a really bad day for you. So please do not do that. All right, the parking lights. It is a purple wire. I don't know if you guys could see this, but I can see 5 purple wires right here, and I had to test every one until I got to the parking light. So I'm gonna use a power probe. You guys can use a multimeter, but basically how this is gonna test out is it's gonna rest at ground. So if I stick this on here, we're gonna be resting at ground. And when I turn parking lights on at the switch up by the steering wheel, it goes to 12 volts right here. So it's gonna go to power, whoops. And then when I turn the switch back off, it's gonna go to ground. Switch on, switch off. You guys have to test for this wire. If you just hook it up to a purple wire and do not test it, you're going to damage something in your vehicle and or our remote start unit. So test this. If you guys hook the remote start up and you don't have a multimeter or a test light, don't hook this up yet. You have to test this wire no matter what. Once you guys locate the right wire, you're gonna go ahead and crimp on our wire tap, just like we did on the green one over there behind the glove box, like this. And then you're gonna take the white wire labeled parking lights from our harness, and you're simply going to strip back a little bit of insulation so some wire is exposed. You're gonna crimp on the red spade and then plug it right back into where we just tapped up by the firewall. And keep in mind, guys, this is optional. It is not required for remote start. The only purpose of this wire is to give you visual confirmation when you remote start the vehicle. So with that said, this is our last connection, and we're gonna go ahead and button this up and get to module programming.
Because firmware and programming can change, we are not going to show that in the video. Please refer to our installation guide for the most up-to-date programming procedure for your remote start kit.
Lock. Lock, lock. Gonna give it a couple seconds to fire everything up. And there she goes. So the doors are locked. And then when you're ready to leave, you can hit the unlock button. You can just get in. Obviously we're still here. Climate controls are on to where we last had them. Put the key in, go 2 clicks, and you can press and release the brake pedal, and now press it, pull it out apart, and